Hi there, Doug Stuman with IT Creations. And today we'll be taking a look at the Gigabyte G262-ZO0 GPU Server. This platform features dual AMD EPYC 7003 series processors with up to 64 physical cores and 128 virtual threads. Those CPUs can be paired with up to four AMD Instinct MI250 OAM form factor GPUs connected via AMD's Infinity Fabric. Like our videos? Hit that subscribe button or give us a thumbs up. It does help the channel. Let's check it out. This platform does have an unusual design, which we will take a look at in a minute. Although in many ways, the system is somewhat simple in that you don't have a choice of GPUs. That said, you do have a choice on all the other hardware like CPUs, memory, and storage. With four GPUs installed in the Gigabyte G262-ZO0 GPU server, this 2U platform is designed for AI, AI training and inference, plus high-performance computing workloads. In addition to third-generation AMD EPYC CPUs, it can also support AMD's third-generation CPUs with 3D V-Cache technology, offering greater L3 cache for applications like computational fluid dynamics, electronic design automation, and structural analysis. It can actually be used to create simulations to test and validate engineering designs prior to creating the real thing. They also provide greater bandwidth and lower latency as a result of that data queuing at the CPU. We didn't put those in this one though. A small control panel on the left front of the system has a few LEDs and buttons for power, reset, a UID button with LED and HDD status and system status below those. The four 2.5-inch hot swap drive bays can be outfitted with SAS, SATA, or Gen 4 NVMe U.2 storage devices. If you choose to install SAS drives, you will need a discrete SAS controller card. Below those bays, there are a few PCIe slots, a dedicated management port to connect to the ASPEED AST2500 baseboard management controller, or BMC, then two 1 gigabit Ethernet RJ45 ports, two USB 3.0 ports, a mini display port. Right next to the management port, an OCP mezzanine card slot for optional OCP. Three large fans on the right are positioned right in front of the GPU stacks. Are you interested in the Gigabyte G262-ZO0 GPU server? If you are, then for a limited time, you can save up to $500 off the purchase price of a system that's listed or one that you can configure at IT Creations that's valued at $5,000 or more. Just click that link to learn more, and when you're ready to make a purchase, just mention this video. We could be sharing acronyms and geek talk in no time. Pre-installed on each server is Gigabyte's management console. It's offered free of charge and allows for real-time monitoring and management of the system through a graphic user interface. Also, automatic event recording, plus monitoring and control of Broadcom MegaRAID adapters. The Gigabyte management console is for a single server. For managing clusters of servers simultaneously over the internet, there's Gigabyte Server Manager, or GSM. GSM complies with Redfish and IPMI standards, has a graphic user interface, or command line interface, and has a plugin for VMware vCenter. To realize the benefits of GSM, you will need to install the GSM agent. There's even a mobile app. With most of the ports located on the front, there's not much to see on the back. However, there are dual redundant 3000 watt 80 plus platinum PSUs. Yes, 3000 watts of power. Once we pop the cover, you see some flimsy air shrouds which direct the air over the parts that generate the most heat. Flimsy, but effective. There is the potential to install up to four PCIe low profile cards in back using those PCIe 4.0 by 16 slots. In this case, there is a ConnectX-6 VPI HDR 200 gigabit Ethernet card offering dual ports for QSFP56 connectors. The non-acronym name is Quad Small Form Factor Pluggable with four 50 gigabit per second channels to achieve that 200 gigabit per second total data rate. And again, those two PCIe 4.0 by 16 slots in front I already mentioned. Those PCIe slots in front are split between CPU 0 and CPU 1. In total, you get six PCIe 4.0 slots with an OCP slot. Regarding those four AMD Instinct MI250 OAM GPU accelerators, and I know what you're thinking, what is an OAM GPU? That is the acronym for Open Accelerator Module, kind of AMD's answer to the NVIDIA SXM form factor, or Server PCI Express module that connect via NVLink. Instead, AMD uses their proprietary Infinity Fabric. Those AMD Instinct MI250 OAM GPUs are based on AMD's CDNA2 architecture and are designed to target AI, machine learning, and high-performance computing workloads. Connected via four of AMD's Infinity Fabric links, the AMD Instinct MI250 can deliver speeds of up to 25 gigatransfers per second, which is equivalent to 200 gigabytes per second, not to be confused with gigabits per second, like on that QSFP56 NIC I just blathered on about. The MI250 also uses HBM2E, which is AMD's high bandwidth memory module, offering a peak memory bandwidth of 1.6 terabytes per graphic compute die, or GCD. HBM2E is twice as fast as HBM2, with double the capacity. All of these compute accelerators in turn connect to the AMD EPYC CPUs and NICs, and presumably NVMe storage devices if we installed NVMe, through PCI switches. Those PCI switches help moderate data flow. This is all getting very abstract and bizarre, and we could definitely run further down the rabbit hole, but let's just move on. Second or third gen AMD EPYC CPUs feature Zen 3 architecture and will provide up to 128 Gen 4 PCI lanes in a single socket implementation. However, you can only get up to 160 PCI 4.0 lanes with dual sockets like we have on this platform. You lose some of those PCI lanes because the CPUs use extra lanes to talk to each other, more or less. Do we really need to talk about the socket-to-socket global memory interface, XGMI, now? No. Moving on, people. We're moving on. Memory channels are at 8 per CPU, and with 16 DIMM slots on the system board, each memory module will occupy its own memory channel for best performance. Registered or load-reduced memory modules are supported on the system for up to 4 terabytes using 3DS versions, or up to 2 terabytes using standard memory modules. This particular platform has AMD EPYC 7763 CPUs with 64 cores and 128 virtual threads, plus 256 megabytes of L3 cache. We installed 2 terabytes of memory using standard 128 gigabyte DDR4 memory modules in all slots. The storage up front flows through CPU 0, but are also connected directly to the PEC switches and AMD Insight GPU accelerators through the PCI lanes. This would be a dual route system, as the GPUs and PCI slots in back and in front are split between the two CPUs, which then communicate between each other. CPU 0 has a single M.2 drive attached, while CPU 1 has direct access to 2 NVMe M.2 drives supported on a riser. All of those M.2 drives are supported in x4 PCI 4.0 slots. Aside from the plethora of acronyms and tangents into theoretical data rates and whatnot, I do hope you enjoyed this short, potentially tedious overview of the Gigabyte G262-ZO0 GPU server. With its very unique chassis design, it delivers the goods and performance you may need while keeping everything cool, even with a power draw that might tax those 3,000-watt PSUs. If you like this video, consider subscribing or give it the thumbs up. Want more information? I placed a few links in the description below, or you can click that link right there to visit itcreations.com. I commend you for making it this far. My brain kind of hurts. Until next time, I'm Doug Stuman with IT Creations. Thanks for watching.